It was a year old temple. Together some devotees started the renovation work of this temple. The pigeons that have been living in the temple for years are confused as to where we are going to live now. The pigeons living in the mosque next door found out about this, so some pigeons came from there and invited the pigeons living in the temple to stay in the mosque for a few months. All the pigeons in the temple went to the mosque to stay. A church was also located in the same area. Church pigeons also received news that the temple pigeons are now taking refuge with the mosque pigeons. Some of the church pigeons went to the mosque and begged the temple pigeons to be their guest for a few days. The temple pigeons also went to church to stay a few days. These pigeons of the temple also became the guest of the pigeons of the Gurudwara for a few days and stay with the pigeons of the Derasar for a few days. When the construction of the temple was completed, the pigeons returned to their original place. A little pigeon asked his elder, "Grandpa, when we went everywhere for a few months, I saw that those who come to temples are called Hindus, those who come to mosque are called Muslims, those who come to church are called Christians, those who come to Gurudwaras are called Sikh, and those who go to Derasar are called Jains." Elder pigeon said, "Son, they are all known by different names because they follow different religions." The baby pigeon was not satisfied, so he asked another question. "Grandpa, we are called pigeons even when we are in the temple and even when we are in the mosque. As all of us pigeons look the same, these people are the same in appearance, so when they go to the temple or a mosque, why not be identified as a man instead of Hindu or Muslim?" The elder pigeon said lovingly to the little one, "Son, we are birds without intelligence and humans are very intelligent. So they have used their intelligence to discriminate. Oh Lord, I pray to you that you destroy our discriminating intellect and give us a dove-like innocence that we can love every human being in your creation. Thank you very much."